A question that any comprehensive philosophy or religion has to deal with, because it's a question that occurs to people's minds, a great existential question, is the question, what exactly is a person? What is a human being? In fact, are human beings persons? Are all human beings persons, or only some human beings? Are there some human beings who are human beings but are not yet persons? Are there some human beings who used to be persons but are no longer persons? Are there some human beings who, due to, say, severe cognitive disability, never were, aren't now, and never will be persons? Are there non-human persons? These are all very important questions. Christianity has a view about them. and the view is very much in line with some aspects or some thinkers in antiquity, but not others. Christianity's view of the human person and the relationship of the person to the body, and its view that all human beings are persons, is in line with Aristotle's view, but not with Plato's. Plato adopted a dualistic view. He thought the real person was the soul, the spirit, and not the body. The body was more like a prison that the spirit was held in temporarily on this earth until death, when the spirit is liberated and then lives in the spirit realm. That kind of dualism has been embraced by other thinkers, including some within the Christian tradition, heretical thinkers within the Christian tradition, heretical on this issue. Descartes, for example, believed that the person was really the soul, not the body. Cartesian dualism, as it's sometimes called, I think is not inaccurately characterized as the idea that persons are ghosts in machines. Human persons are ghosts in machines. The body's a machine, and the spirit is the ghost, or the soul is the ghost that inhabits the machine and until death. Now, the temptation to think that way, even, or perhaps you might say especially for Christians, is that we do believe as Christians in the spiritual soul. We're not materialists. We don't reduce everything to the physical. We don't think that the body is all there is. And we certainly don't think that when the body dies, that's it. We believe that the soul is immortal, and that our physical death, while real death, is not the end of the story. And yet, as I said earlier, Christianity comes down on the side of Aristotle, not Plato. So what was Aristotle's view? Aristotle did not think that the body and soul were separable as two distinct substances. He saw the human being as a unity of body and soul, a dynamic unity. The body is not merely the vehicle in which the person considered as the spiritual soul resides and can someday leave. The body is part of the reality of the human being. So is the soul. And there's a relationship of body and soul, of course. And the body is not immortal. The soul is immortal. Christianity believes that in any case. So how do we make sense of all that?